Mr. Nikhil Modi, I am thankful to you giving me opportunity to come and express my views on the port logistics in dry bulk cargoes. So for the break bulk cargoes there, mostly it is taken over into container. Now it is reduced substantially. Now ports are based only in the dry bulk cargo. I am from Kandla port, exclusively Kandla port. I don't operate any other port except Kandla port, and I will never operate. I will give you now, sir, the Kandla port is serving all interland of the northern India, right from Jammu Kashmir. And bulk cargo, break bulk cargo is mostly is a coal in a big way, iron ore, iron steel pellets are there, fertilizer. We are serving to the industries. And so far export is concerned, we are doing the export of the wheat in the bulk, we are doing the wheat, soybean meal, etc. Now since ports sector is servicing the industries, it is unfortunately on our part that port industry don't understand that we had to give the cargo to the industry raw material as cheaper as possible. But it is unfortunate that we don't think for that. We just go on increasing our logistic cost. Today, industry is in a big problem. They don't have margin of the profits. They want to reduce even 1 rupee if possible, they will reduce it. Old time has gone when industries has to use Kandla port. Then they will compare. They don't see the service provider of the Kandla port, but they see what is their cost, total logistic cost, when they bring the vessel to major port Kandla or Naulaki or Pipava or Mundra or Beri. These are the five ports. Wherever 1 rupee cheaper is there, they will go. As a result, Kandla port this year lost 6 million ton cargo. Every year there is an increase of 10%, against which they lost 6 million ton cargo. Our neighbor port got 100 million ton cargo. I congratulate them. We are not ready to understand why we are losing the traffic. As someone said, major ports, their investment is zero because whatever construction of jetty they made before 20 years, 30 years, they got it. Still, we want to increase the cost. Kandla port, since last year, Kandla port wanted to increase the tariff by 84%. I lead this, went to the secretary, I told them, are you going to ruin the port? 84% you are going to increase. Can they pay you? No. Even the present logistic cost are very high. How we expect 84% further they will give to them? But it is also a fact, Kandla port is losing in dry cargo. They are subsidizing from the liquid cargo or Varina. This loss is due to the reason that they don't understand what they should invest and how to invest, necessity or not necessity, just throwing the money. No, we want 14 meter draft. Go on increasing the money. Now, Kandla port is increasing the draft from 12 meter to 13 meter. Because they are committed to the PPP model, they will give them 13 meter draft. And spending 300 crore rupees on that, 200 crore rupees on rail and road connectivity, 500 crore. Now, 500 crore they have to recover from the four private PPP model berths, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Now, 2, 14 and 16 have disappeared. Now they are 13, 15. 15 births was in operation since last 4-5 months. Within 5 months they have done not even one vessel. 13 also we are not going to do more than 1 million. So from 1 million cargo, how 500 crore rupees they will make it? Ultimately this 500 crore rupees they will require from existing 12 berths. So our costs, they are increasing. We are loading every day maximum 2 rakes, but they put 12 lines. Where 12 rakes they will do it. How much cost? 150 crore rupees. From where you are going to recover, you will add into the SR, in this SOR. So till these people, government people, don't go into reality that they should not waste your money, reduce their logistic cost, then only they have got survival. Otherwise, this private port will totally take over the major ports. Sir. In case this major port believes increasing, they think that they are losing traffic because their draft is less. Not so. Draft is not a reason. Because in Kandla, we have got 2 floating cranes, we have got 32 barges. We can do light rakes 15,000 ton in 24 hours. If the vessel comes in 14 meter, we can make it required draft only in 24 hours only. And average cost will not be more than 15-20 rupees a ton. Why you are investing 500 crore rupees? Your additional traffic will be 2 million ton million, but the cost will be distributed to the entire cargo. It is increasing. So these things, they add to it. Sir, so when I say total logistic cost, means freight of the vessel, port handling cost, and secondary transportation. We cannot handle, major port cannot handle a bigger vessel, where the cost they can save. Therefore, bigger vessel going towards the private ports. Fortunately, Kandla is handling it. Then, logistic cost, which major port will never understand, it will go on increasing. And the secondary transportation by road and rail. In Manikoram, we are talking about coastal movement, coastal movement. Coastal movement cannot be successful in India. Don't look towards China where coastal movement is success. It cannot be in Kandla because our industries are not water-based. These secondary transportation at both ends is so costly that whatever you are saving in the coastal movement, you are losing there. Even more than that, you are losing it. I tried one experiment, bringing iron ore from Hospet via water. We brought it by road to Goa. Goa loaded the barges. Again, barges unloaded in Kandla, put the cargo in Kandla port, then secondary transportation to industry. So freight was only 600-700 rupees in those days, but the other logistic came 1200 rupees. So more than the coastal freight, twice is the cost of the logistic of the other sector. If both ends are in water, like China, then only we can survive. Otherwise, coastal will be only on talks, on discussion. Coastal cannot be successful in India. Now, unfortunately, Kandla and Mundra, the whole belt is the water-based. But industry are 50 kilometers away. If these people, port authorities, government of India, make canal or basin near 3-5 kilometers from the port, with the environment sector, and join it with the small canal, and cargo from barges come directly in from the canal to the basin, and industry are basin-based, then coastal movement will start. But this is not coming in your way. Sir, near Kandla, there is a place, Jakhau, where 30 million ton industry, cement industry is coming up. Already 7 million ton production is there. and within 2-3 years it will be 25-30 million. Unfortunately, there is no rail connectivity and road movement is very high. They have got the jetty or barge, they can do water movement. And since years I am writing to Kandla Port or Government of India, why don't you make a basin in Kandla and join it with the water, so that these barge can, cargo can, iron can bring from Jakhau, unload in here, and they just do here bagging and crushing. But government is silent. So this government, main thing is our bureaucracy. They don't understand what is really required, what is benefit of the country. They are silent and they just go on spending money like this, we'll do like this, we'll do like this, but nothing is done. It is unfortunately that this country, because of the shipping is the sector which making our Indian economy failure. Industry's growth is very, very low. Now WTO agreement they have signed, and they cannot stop China and other countries dumping their cargo in India. Now, because of the lower cost, they are bringing Chinese cargo is dumping in India, and our industry, Indian industry, cannot make it because their cost is very high. And so far export is there, they talk, foreign exchange is not there, balance is very problem. But how you can do export? WTO agreement you have signed that on food grain export they will not give any subsidy, while we are habitual of subsidies. Without government subsidy we cannot do any work. In export of food grain they buy from farmer at very high rates, logistic costs are very high, and whatever short is there we give them a subsidy. Now subsidy is stopped. Now wheat export, according to total cost, FOB cost of the wheat is $271-$272, and government agreed basic price 260 plus. Immediately USA and Canada put them on notice. No, your cost is 271-272. If you are selling 260, then $11 you have to give the subsidy. You can't do it, and they stop it. And now the price is 285-290. This is the right time. Then they say, no, we are waiting, how much crop was damaged. Then we say, you have got a surplus cargo for 3 years. This is the time you have to export it, do it. After 2 months, again they will come, we will export it. Then again, 272, you will not get it. So these are the things for which our export